there is a cautionary tale for America, it's Europe. If you want to know what we're going to look like in 5 to 10 years, look to Europe. My next speaker is the Danish leader of Stop the Islamization of Denmark, Stop the Islamization of Europe. Anders Gravis is my colleague. I am proud and honored to introduce you to him. Anders?
It's been 10 years, but it seems like only yesterday. When we meet again in 10 years' time, it will still seem like only yesterday. Today is a day of remembrance, a day for peace in this great city of New York, a day for contemplation. This is my second visit to New York, and what strikes me most is this kindness and courtesy of the people here. New York mirrors America, and the people of New York mirror the American people. There is without doubt an overriding kindness about America and the American people. However, 10 years ago, today a great cruelty descended upon New York and America. A cruelty that whatever critics might say was not of America's making. It was a cruelty alien to American principles, a cruelty born out of a hatred for the kindness and freedom Americans aspire to. 10 years ago today, innocent people, not only Americans, were going about their ordinary lives. Some were at work, some on airplanes, planning to visit families and friends, harming no one. These poor people fell victim to a long-lasting hatred of kindness and freedom. They fell victim to what can only be described as evil. Truly, it was evil. And let us remember, there are people here today who are also victims of that terrible hatred. I speak not only of the families who grieve for the loss of their innocent and loved ones. We must also remember those who are suffering terrible illness because of the dust clouds that enveloped New York. Indeed, many have died over the past 10 years because of illness caused by those evil attacks. Doctors tell us that maybe more people will suffer illness in the future caused by the actions of terrorists whose only motive was to malice. Pray God that those who suffer illness in the future are few. The images of the planes crashing into the Twin Towers are sentient in the minds of decent people. We must understand that the 200 people who left to their deaths from the towers did not kill themselves. They had no intention of hurting themselves or others when they entered the house, these impressive buildings that day. They went into those buildings to earn an honest living. They perhaps just went to meet friends for a coffee. Whatever they did, it was not done for cruelty. Let's be assured that for every person who fell from those buildings, a soul arose, a magnificent soul. Let us be assured for the thousands who perished inside those falling buildings, thousands of magnificent souls arose from the clouds of destruction. Each soul born out of kindness and love, each soul returned to kindness and love. Let us remember those innocent who perished in the Pentagon working to keep the free world safe. And those on the flights 11, 77, 93, and 175. Their souls fly on. And of course, the people of the free world must always remember the first responders. Well, at least those who love the free world will always remember the first responders. Unfortunately, some misguided people seem to have forgotten that some more worthy persons gave up their lives to help the unfortunate folk inside the Twin Towers. Well, there are those of us here today who will never forget, and we will let it be known to the world that we thank the first responders. When we need you, you are there for us, and we thank you. And we say to the families of those first responders who gave up their lives, we love you, loved ones, as if they were our brothers and sisters. For that is what they were, and that is what they are. All those innocent people who perished on this day 10 years ago, and all those who are suffering the aftermath of this act of cruelty. Every one of you is our brother and sister in freedom. And this is it, people. Those innocent who died, those who still suffer, and those who remember, we are still united in freedom. And freedom means kindness, not cruelty. Freedom is the right to choose. Democracy provides that right to choose. Democracy is born out of kindness, not cruelty towards our fellow man. The American Constitution enshrines the freedom of religion. It does not enshrine the freedom of any religion to behave cruelty and to smother freedom. In the middle of the sorrow of all these people we lost, we must never forget why the terror attack took place. This happened because attempts are made to impose Islamic law in the United States. Terror attacks are Islamic tactics to terrify people till they submit to Islam. That's why we owe the victims and the bereaved not to be terrified. We owe the victims and the bereaved to stop Islamic law wherever its cruel phrase shows. Stop the mosque. Stop every attempt to oppose Islamic law. So as well as remembering the innocent who suffered and lost their lives 10 years ago today. Let's all honor them. Let's honor them by peacefully and firmly fighting for the freedom and democracy we cherish. Let's deny those who wish us to surrender to cruelty. Let's be kind. Let's roll.